What if you buy a camper or motorhome, use it a few times, and then you realize this is just not going to work for you? Avoid these RV buying mistakes next. Welcome to the channel. I'm Liz. I'm a full-time RVer. I've been on the road for 4 years, and I've talked to lots of camping neighbors in that time who bought the wrong camper. I have a neighbor right here in this campground who bought a used motorhome, paid $85,000 for it less than a year ago, and she just traded it in for a different one. She only got $50,000 for her old motorhome. So in this video, I'm gonna help you avoid RV buying mistakes. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. If you want more, if you wanna meet me, have lunch, or even go hiking with me, join my Patreon. It's very easy when you're RV shopping, particularly if you're going to a dealership or an RV show, to get caught up in the moment. There's so many bells and whistles and wow, all the places we'll go and look at all those windows. It's so easy to get so caught up that you buy the wrong RV. And it's not until you use it a few times do you realize, oh my gosh, this is a deal breaker. If I could do it all over again, I definitely would not have bought this camper. So we're gonna talk about your non-negotiable list, how to avoid this mistake from the get-go. So if you don't already have it, grab a pen and paper. Now let's go right to the bedroom. This is one of the most overlooked areas in RV buying. I actually met someone who bought their RV, slept in it one night, and took it right back. Fortunately, the dealership worked with him. So what happens is you walk into an RV, you get so wowed by all the stuff in the kitchen and the living room and all this great stuff that you look at the bedroom and you're like, oh yeah, it's fine, I can sleep there. Well, really think about what else you might want to do in your bedroom. Make sure that you can sit up in bed. Make sure if you're a couple that there's room for what you want to do. If you're looking at a Class C and you know the bed that's over the cab, that may not allow you to sit up in bed. Same way with a mid or low profile fifth wheel. And no matter what camper you're looking at, sometimes they put those cabinets in inconvenient places. Now, while we're talking about the bedroom, a nightstand and an outlet is not a guarantee. So you definitely want to look at that. If you use a CPAP machine, then you definitely need a nightstand. You need a place to put that. I came from a brand new Grand Design fifth wheel. I swear the nightstand was just like a ledge. It would not have held a CPAP machine. So make sure that you have that space in the bedroom as well as an outlet, because often there's not an outlet on each side of the bed. Now let's go back to the kitchen, the heart of the home, right? Think about how you want to use your camper. Do you want to go way out in the woods? Do you want to go up to the mountains? Well, the refrigerator is what will bring you back sooner. So make sure that your fridge is big enough and the freezer to hold everything that you want. Now, a lot of people overlook counter space. If you're cooking at the stove, you need to have that space, you know, to put a plate or a cutting board. You would not believe how many kitchens I've seen in campers that just are really hard to cook in. That's a problem that you just can't fix. And then every day you're like, oh my God, I hate this kitchen. I hate cooking in here. You know, and not every meal is gonna be over the fire or, you know, using the outdoor kitchen. You need to make sure that indoor kitchen works for you. Think about pantry space. This is often overlooked. So make sure that you have the storage, particularly if you're gonna go on long trips and you're not gonna be near the store. Also think about who you'll be camping with. Are you a family? Are you bringing grandkids along? Make sure that the table will absolutely seat everyone and that everyone can be comfortable. Now, here's a common mistake in the living area, particularly if you're buying an older motorhome. There's probably a place for everyone to sit and be comfortable no matter what you're buying. You do want to make sure that everyone has a place to sit and be comfortable and relax. But in an older motorhome, they often put the couch along the side, of course, but the TV over the cab. So you're watching TV like this. You're sitting at the couch and looking like that. How soon would that get old? I have met countless neighbors who have older motorhomes who've told me, this is the one thing I don't like. I am now motorhome shopping again because I don't like this. Now, in some cases you can fix it. You can maybe add a pop-up TV, but in a lot of cases, there's just no fixing that. You would not believe how small some of these bathrooms are. When you're looking at an RV, everyone who's going to be using that RV, make sure that they sit on the toilet and stand in the shower. There are some toilet rooms that are so small that you might not be able to fit in it. So make sure that you can sit down on the toilet and that you can stand back up. This is another one of those problems that it can definitely be a deal breaker. In the shower, you want to stand in there and make sure that you can wash your hair, shave your legs, you know, make sure that it'll work for you. A common complaint I hear from other campers is there's no place for coats, no place for shoes. This is a biggie and can definitely add to your stress if you're a neatnik and you want to have a place for everything. It can kind of be a problem if you're tripping over shoes, right? So look around and make sure that it will accommodate that. Check the outside storage. You want to bring a patio mat, maybe a grill, some chairs. Make sure that you have all that. It's worth it to take the time now versus having a kind of an ugly surprise later, right? Don't allow yourself to get wowed, to get swept up in everything that you overlook. You really want to slow down. Maybe tell that salesman to go take a walk. Go through your day and really think about living in it, particularly if you're going to be full time, but even on a weekend or long trips, definitely take your time and go through all of it. Now, a huge mistake that a lot of people make is they don't know how much their truck can pull. If you're looking at getting a travel trailer or a fifth wheel, do the research first. Know what your truck will pull, and then also know how to read the weights on the fifth wheel or travel trailer. You want to make sure that you're reading the loaded weight, not the dry weight. Dry weight means there's no water in it, no cargo, no people. I almost bought a Navion or a Winnebago View until I found that the cargo carrying capacity wasn't enough. So you can't just look at the storage and say, okay, there's enough room for all my things, because a lot of them have a lot of storage, but not enough CCC. If you're a minimalist, you can make it work, or if you're a weekender, you can probably make it work. In my situation, I am neither. So that number was a deal breaker for me right from the get-go. Also, if you're going to be camping for long periods at state parks, national parks, they don't have sewer hookups. So the longer you can stay in your spot without having to go to the dump station, that is awesome. So you want to see how big your black and your gray tanks are, as well as your fresh water tank. If you're boondocking, then you're going to be using your fresh water tank. Now, about that non-negotiable list, as you work on it, make sure that your spouse, your other family members are in agreement that this is the list and this is what we agree to. We won't buy an RV if it doesn't check all the boxes on this list. I think the most important thing to do when you go RV shopping is to bring that non-negotiable list with you. Take this list out before you sign on the dotted line. If you've enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, and share, and let me know what's on your non-negotiable list. I'd love to hear it. Remember, these are exciting times to push past fear, build confidence, and live amazing.